This is the Meritage Resort and Spa in Napa, California. And like other hotels and resorts across the country, a number of workers here were let go amid the coronavirus pandemic, including these Filipino J1 visa holders who lost their jobs toward the end of March.
It's hard because we paid so much money for this program, and it's not fair because some of the agencies doesn't care because they're just like forcing us to go home. And like, this opportunity already came, and it's hard to like just throw it away.
J1 holders are temporary non-immigrant visas from the U.S. for those who participate in work and study exchange visitor programs. According to the workers, the program costs them about 300,000 pesos, or about $6,000.
We talked about
the workers are holding on to some hope that as California begins to ease restrictions, it might mean they can go back to work. Typically, J1 visa holders who lose their jobs have 60 days until they lose their visa status. Unfortunately, the resort cannot guarantee anything for them yet. These Filipinos are taking part in a year-long food and beverage paid internship program.
Is there any assurance that the company will accept us even though the crisis is over? So their answer is there's no assurance because the first priority is the regular ones, the regular employee.
I really love my work. That's why I came to the United States for me to learn, to adapt, to get knowledge, for me to be able to use this knowledge that I've learned here in the U.S. through my future career.
Meanwhile, these J1 visa holders have been leaning on the support of the Filipino-American community and organizations such as Migrante, the National Alliance for Filipino Concerns, and the Pinoy Masons of Northern California that have provided them groceries and assisted them with other needs as they go through these challenging times. Ramel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, American Canyon, California.